Because
they. All right. First and foremost, I want to start off by saying, Kol Halo Yahweh, Bahashem Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rakal Kodash. Double honors to the apostles of GMS who rule well and who taught me this truth. And shalom to you, sincere Akim out there listening, learning, and pushing this truth. And I'm not going to make this video too long. I just wanted to do this video in light of everything that's going on, you know, with the Adam Abbot and whatnot. You know, the year is drawn to an end. We're coming to the end of 2018. Thought I'd do this video. It's well deserved. You know what I'm saying? Hold on, it's a lot here. I'm gonna play what the apostles said just now, but wanted to bring a couple scriptures out first. As we always say, double honors, and I just wanted to show you, brothers, where we get this from. You know what I'm saying? 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 17. It says, "Let the elders that rule well be counted worthy of double honor, especially they who labor in the word and doctrine." And definitely from the head apostle, Elder Apostle Tahar, on down, they definitely labor in the word and doctrine, okay? And they rule well, and they are worthy of their double honors, okay? With that being said, I wanted you to hear a little bit of this classic. I guess this is off of Sign Niggas, Sign Niggas TV, but this is, it says, GMS Apostles, the Classics, Volume 1. The elders, GMS Hebrew Israelites. I'll let you hear some of this. I'll get into the scriptures. It's fitting because, you know, this is the flavor of the week is, you know, Adam Abbot and the RFID microchip. And this is a, like I said, an old throwback video.
Because they want to get the Rothschilds and the elites.
The elites.
And they want to get rid of the money system. Now everything is credit cards, man. You go to Macy's and pay something with cash, they're going to look at you funny.
They're making commercials like that.
They're making commercials about that,
where they scoff at cash.
So what they want people, they want to get rid of the paper dollar system, and they want to put the debit cards. Then from the debit cards, eventually what they're going to do is they're going to have you take this chip.
That's right.
And the masses of the people don't know what it's all about.
Right.
And the only place that it's mentioned is in the Bible. It's not mentioned in the Quran. It's not mentioned in the Kibra Nigas, the Metaneta, Epic of Gilgamesh. It's not mentioned. The only book that is mentioned is in the scriptures. That's why it says no one should have a mate. What's that? Isaiah 34 and 16. Go ahead and read it.
Isaiah 34:16. Seek ye out the book of the Lord and read. No one of these shall fail. None shall want her mate.
Lockie, like I said, it's a good video, you know, but I just wanted to see, you know, so you could see we've been pushing this RFID, and he's been pushing it way before this, like I said, and that's what we said, that's what the scripture said. Timothy, and Apostle Tahar, Elder Apostle Tahar, rightfully so, named this year the year of prophecy. The prophecies are screaming, okay? Okay, I'll show you one prophecy that's being fulfilled right now, okay? This is a prophecy, and it's being fulfilled right now. It says, I started 4:2. 2 Timothy 4, verse 2. It says, "Preach the word, be instant, in season and out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long-suffering and doctrine." And that's what GMS does, and that's what we were doing. We were rebuking, you know, reproving. That's what the scriptures say to do, okay? But check this out, verse 3. "For the time will come," this is why you're supposed to do this, man. This is a commandment, man. Okay? It says, "For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine." And that a lot of you, these guys, like Adam Abbot, they're not, you know, he claims he learned from Apostle Tahar, but he's not enduring in sound doctrine. Okay? Okay? "For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. But after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears." And I that's the main reason why I wanted to do this scripture, because when I just keep going back to his page just to see if he's going to ever address it, which I know he's not, because he's not a man of the Lord. That's already been proven just by his interactions with the elders that are, like the scripture said, on Apostle Gabar, his GMS Walk and Talk 8. You can see how he interacted with the elders. No respect. You know, just complete reprobate. Okay? Completely not scriptural, man. Even their character, and they pose as humble, but they're not. It says, for the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth. And the truth of the matter is, like we keep telling you, the mark of the beast is the RFID microchip, and shall be turned unto fables. But watch thou in all the things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry. And that's what we're doing. We're making full proof of our ministry. Everything we say, we back it up. And that's why you feel like you're being persecuted. Because we make full proof of our ministry. We prove all things. We prove it with the scriptures. We prove it with the Hebrew. We prove it with, news articles coming out. We prove it with actual events that are taking place currently. How can you deny it? Okay? And I got another scripture I wanted to prove. But this is why everybody, we didn't attack this guy first, man. He called out apostles to heart. If you go back and rewatch the live stream, the old boy with the dreads, he called out apostles to heart. Wasn't nobody just banging on these guys, man. But what happens is we have the truth. And everybody, and we boldly claim that we have 100% truth, okay? And people can't resist. Luke 21 and 15. For I will give you a mouth and wisdom which all your adversaries shall not be able to gainsay nor resist. And that's what happened. They could not resist. He was fine in his little lane over there, but he could not resist. He had to open his big mouth and jump on the doctrine and say the RFID microchip is not the chip. Okay? But that ultimately the Lord did that, man, because this is the year of prophecy. All these prophecies have to be fulfilled. And you seeing them live and direct. The year is coming to a close, and you see the Lord is putting the scoffers, put everything in the forefront. The RFID chip, the rumors of wars, everything is right there, fresh in the mind. So there's going to be no excuse. Who knows what next year has in store? Lord's willing, we out of here next year. Lord's willing, but you know. I see this as a year of prophecy, man, and the prophecies are screaming. You've seen everything, man. You've seen everything. Amos 9 and 9. For lo, I will command and I will sift the house of Israel among all nations, like as corn is sifted in a sieve, yet shall not the least grain fall upon the earth. All the sinners of my people shall die by the sword, which say the evil shall not overtake nor prevent us. All right, and that's what you say when you say the mark of the beast is not the microchip, man. You're saying that you know you're going against the Lord, man. You're being adverse to him, man. You know, the scriptures clearly tell you that there's going to be a mark put it in you, in your right hand or the forehead, inserted into you, and no man shall be able to buy or sell with it. But you being wicked and don't want to receive it, man. So guess what? You're going to die. You're going to die a grievous death. All right. I got another one. Matthew 17 and 17. Then Yahushua answered and said, O faithless and perverse generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I suffer you? Bring him hither to me. The main point that I wanted to pull out of this is that like Yahushua said, this is a faithless and perverse generation, man. Like the scripture said, that faithless. Okay. Faithless. They don't show honor to the men that are laboring in the doctrine, that are worthy. No respect. You see? Like the scripture said, this is prophecy. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears. And like I said, that's what you see, man. That's what you see. A faithless, perverse generation, man. A faithless and perverse generation. That heap to themselves teachers with itching ears. You learn from Apostle Hart, but you wanna pick and choose what you wanna believe. You see, perverse. But this is I got another scripture. This is why you guys don't get it, because the Lord really ain't dealing with you. You're not really prophets. You're not servants of the Lord. Amos 3 and 7. Surely the Lord Yahweh will do nothing, but he revealeth his secret unto his servants the prophets. And he does that through men, starting with the head apostle, Apostle Tahar, on down, man. He revealed his secrets unto his prophets, the mysteries, the deep, dark sayings, man. Okay? Let me see. I'm gonna shut it down. I got one more I wanted to get. Because, oh boy, that's another thing they were saying. You guys, any Israelite that think you got all the truth, you don't know nothing. You don't know. No, you don't know nothing. You haven't eaten the whole roll. You haven't digested the whole roll. Why? Because you have no faith and it wasn't given to you because you're not a man of the Lord. The Lord ain't dealing with you. This is 1 John 2:20. But ye have an unction from the Holy One. Who is the Holy One? Yahawashi, Hamashiach. Okay? And ye know all things. Why? Because he's the comforter. He said he's not going to be here, but he was going to leave us a comforter. The comforter is the scriptures. Okay? The Rakakwadash, the Holy Spirit, the wisdom and the ability to understand the scriptures, man. He left that. He gave that to us, man. It says, but ye have an unction from the Holy One and ye know all things. I have not written unto you because ye know not the truth, but because ye know it. And that no lies of the truth. Okay? But that's the main point that I wanted to get, man. Real simple, straightforward, and to the point. This is the year of prophecy, and everything, the scoffers got to come. The scripture said in the last day, the scoffers were going to come. You know, the scripture said, what if the unbelief? You know, what about the unbelievers? You know, is that going to make the word of the Lord void? Hell nah. Yahweh forbid, man. These niggas are liars. What the Lord said is going to come to pass. And in that day, they are going to know who the Lord's chosen was. They are going to know that a prophet had been amongst them, that the prophets were back, and that the prophets warned them. The RFID microchip is the mark of the beast, and it's going to come upon the whole world. You're going to everyone is going to be faced with that hour of temptation, that decision, whether you're going to choose, follow Esau Edom, who is a so-called white man, and take that chip, or whether you're going to serve Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, and not take that chip. Anyway, with that being said, hopefully it was edifying. Like I said, I didn't want to make it too long. Like I said, we almost out of here, man. The year is almost over, man. We in November, you know. We coming up in December. Today's the 30th. You know what I'm saying? The year is almost, we got one more month. You know what I'm saying? We almost out of here, man. Things are going to speed up. I know things are going to speed up. The Lord is, you know, sealing the elect right now, sifting us, getting us strong. They talking about they not being fucking persecuted. Persecuted for what, a lie? No, we are being persecuted. We are the men of the Lord. We have the truth. But anyway, with that being said, I'm going to say Shalom.